Blackstone Audio presents Loving Robert Lowell by Sandra Hochman. This book is read by Dawn Harvey.
For my beautiful friend, Emily McAllister.
Chapter 1. Cal.
It was spring of 1961. I had found a part-time job. Then something fortuitous happened. My friend and literary mentor, James T. Farrell, suggested I interview Robert Lowell for Encounter magazine. I knew Encounter was a prestigious magazine in London, where Stephen Spender and many other literary people wrote interviews and articles and published poetry. James T. Farrell had pull with Mr. Lasky, the editor. James also knew I needed extra money, and he admired my literary interviews that had been published in some small magazines. He was always generous about helping me publish. "The Lowells have just moved to New York City from Boston," James said, giving me Robert Lowell's private phone number. "I'm sure Lowell would be flattered to have you interview him. He loves promoting himself, and a lot of people are now talking about his poetry. His book, Life Studies, which came out last year, was controversial but got such rave reviews. Now that he's almost a mainstream writer, people want to know everything about him, especially in England where Faber and Faber is publishing all his books and T.S. Eliot is his editor and close friend."
"But what makes you think Robert Lowell will talk to me?" I asked.
"Of course he'll talk to you if I tell him to. What man doesn't want to talk to a pretty young intellectual interviewer?" I remember the day I interviewed Robert Lowell. It was a warm and sunny Friday when my boss, Mr. Moss, went out to lunch. I summoned my nerve and dialed the Lowell number that James T. Farrell had given me. I was not really nervous about writing interviews. Interviews for me were like watercolor portraits, and I was good at writing them. I remembered that Robert Lowell had been such a gentleman when I met him 5 years previously in Cambridge. I knew that to write a great interview, one had to be an artist and gently run your brush on the inner life of the person you were talking to. I mused about the inner life of Robert Lowell. What was he really like? I knew he was Catholic and had been a conscientious objector during World War II. But how do you get into the mind of a genius? I was afraid he would say no, but I summoned my courage anyway. I dialed the number. After a few rings, Robert Lowell answered. I recognized his soft voice with that slight southern accent from when I had briefly audited his class at Boston University. I said my name. "I hope you remember me," I said shyly into the phone. Then he asked me a surprising question.
"What do you look like?"
he asked. Obviously, my name meant nothing to him, and he did not remember me at all. I didn't take this personally. After all, he had taught hundreds of young female students since I had met him in 1955. Silence. I thought for a moment how to answer. "Well, I'm 5'3", average athletic body, green eyes, blonde and brownish hair." I was mortified to have to describe myself physically over the phone. I wish I could have told him something more exotic or more literary. Suddenly, something clicked in his mind. He now remembered who I was.
"Oh, yes. You're the girl Jim Farrell said was a good poet," he said.
I felt relieved. I continued talking. I explained it would be very gracious of him if he allowed me to interview him for an article that James assured me he could place in Encounter magazine. He sounded friendly. There was nothing snobbish or conceited about Robert Lowell. In fact, he seemed very modest. I held his voice to my ear. It was thrilling. It was as if I were light years away from him, but through the black magic of copper wire, he was speaking through my ear into my soul. My heart was now beating fast.
"And where will this interview take place?" he asked me with unexpected interest and enthusiasm.
I wasn't expecting this question. I immediately thought, "Oh my God, what restaurant can I invite him to? I'm broke."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.